pretty much almost there.
Matt's still driving. Pretty much we're low on gas right now, so we're a little bit scared.
Alright.
Just kidding.
Been around like this much gas for like 2 weeks at home.
Yeah, so Matt knows his car, so he knows that. He knows his car well. We're in the wilderness right now. Saw a few dinosaurs on the way back. On the way back there. This is the city of Monterey. We're almost nearing the water. We just passed the mouths of the Laguna Seca of the raceway. Estimated time of arrival is about 4:51. It's 4:43, so we'll see how good the navigation is right on. And there you can see there's some water on the right on that map. We're going down the road. We're going down, further down is our spot.
Super 8? Yeah, for today.
We're glad we're not staying at that Jack in the Box parking lot right there.
Oh, man.
Not even calm, I'll tell you.
Oh, yes,
it's
not
good. Look at it, it's changing. It's at 451, not 454.
So, you just want a navigation, it's going to be on purpose.
Arriving at destination on right.
Where's the thing at?
Super 8, right here.
Right
there. You can just park in the parking lot or somewhere around there. Oh yeah.
Well, this is I think service like.
We are here.
We're
here.
The jacuzzi says it's closed.
It is.
What kind of shit is
that? Shit, we're going to the Howard Johnson. What was the whole point of this?
Nothing like this. I don't know, you can just park anywhere, man. Maybe we just go to the check-in thing.
That's
James' favorite car, the Nissan Cube right there.
Oh, no. You can pay me to charge that.
Alright. We're here, James.
And we're here! Oh. Alright, this is Matt now behind the camera. David, I was behind the wheel.
You got night vision on the thing?
Yeah, I don't think I absolutely need it right now. Andy's still up front. James is still right here. He's chilling right here. We had to sneak him in and out of the hotel right now. It's all good. We got it.
Not to mention we got a haunted hotel.
Yeah, we got a haunted hotel, believe it or not. What are the odds? We're going to Alcatraz at night tomorrow to see ghosts and we can get one in the Super 8 Motel in Monterey.
we'll explain what the situation, we'll reenact it when we get back to the room.
Yeah, when we get back to the room, we'll reenact what happened. Right now, we just left the hotel and we're getting ready to go up towards Fisherman Wharf, get some grub, go see what's up. We're pretty much the only Mexicans in Monterey. And here it is, we're busting a UE right here, and we're off. So, I will sign back in when we get to Fisherman's Wharf. Peace out. All right. We are walking the streets of Monterey. Let's go look over there. We just got out of Bubblegum Shrimps. Explain what just happened.
Okay, this is what went down. We got this waiter.
So can I get you gentlemen something more to drink?
A real seemed like a nice guy, but the guy was out to just take all our money, all our traveling money. So our
bill, swindler.
He was a swindler. He got Matt for 23 something. And we thought we were paying $12. He got James to get this weird dish that
he didn't even like.
He hated it. James didn't like.
I want to puke it up.
Oh, Andy, I think he was cool. He knew what
he was doing. He knew exactly what he was doing.
He knew what he was getting to. And I ordered just enough, but the bill turned out to be $108, right? So, you know, I just, we take out the cash and I, you know, I just.
We look like we're balling.
We look like we're balling and I just tell them, you know, you just keep that.
Yeah. Granted, the change was like $5, but just us saying you keep the change sounded pretty dope.
It sounded really good.
That's the ocean out there. It's pretty dark right now. See the beach. James is freaking freezing.
Yes, sir.
$0.25 to do this?
This is the city of Monterey.
Yeah.
And all its beautiful people. Beautiful white people.
Telling me that was interesting.
There's the fish hopper.
Their first dance.
It may not look as beautiful on camera out there, but it is right now. All you know is you need to hide your kids, hide your wife, because seagulls are raping everybody out here. According to James, according to James, seagulls are raping everybody out here. You don't have to come and confess. We're looking for you. We gon' find you. We gon' find you. So you can run and tell that. Run and tell that. Run and tell that. Homeboy. Homeboy.
Okay, so when we came in this bathroom, this door right here was completely locked. This door was locked right here. No one locked it. No one closed it. So this could be a haunted bathroom. Could be. Outside this window is the Chainsaw Texas Massacre's home. Actually, I'm gonna close that right now.
Open it.
Okay, Matt wants to open it. Didn't come. So we'll see. We'll see what, if anything happens.
So we're gonna be busy by Moon Ross today.
Moon Ross.
All hail Moon Ross.
Moon Ross.
Alright, we're back in the hotel for the final night watching Family Guy. We came back from going to eat at Bubblegum's out there at Cannery Row. Where we got ripped off several times.
Oh, I beg your pardon.
Back in the haunted motel, Super 8, with our ghost known as Moon Ross.
Chris Griffin. Griffin. I'm sorry, sir. Chris.
James is right there. I don't know if you can see it. Let me try this night mode for one more time.
Meg, are you ready? Sweetie, what's wrong?
Did nothing.
Mom, I can't do it.
He's dead asleep. I'm pretty sure David R. is dead asleep.
Because I'm not pregnant.
Zandy.
What do you mean? How do you know?
Same no, what
period.
Up.
Ow. I must have read the test wrong.
We're hoping you don't wake up.
Michael's out there waiting for me.
And there's blood on the wall.
The best thing you can do is be honest.
Hail Moon Ross.
Hail Moon Ross. Oh, and just to inform you, everyone there at home, I did manage to eat a pound and a half of shrimp at Bubba Gums. Did I not, Andy?
You did, but you also got ripped off for it.
I got ripped off for it, but I took that pound and a half of shrimp to school, man. But I'm paying for it now. So, we will see you tomorrow on our way to San Francisco.
So,
we will
keep you posted till then. Good night.
Oh, Michael, I love you too.
And for God's sakes, let Moon Ross let us live one more time.
Peace out. Alright, it's morning time. Going out to get our breakfast.
Car's still there.
Matt says his car's still there. You see, it's a nice sunny day. Really just warming up right now.
Beautiful Monterey.
We'll have a full review with everybody. Including James.
He is still technically hiding out in the hotel.
Exactly. So, nothing happened really last night. Nothing to report, unfortunately. Unless we were messed up in our sleep and we were just so passed out.
Yeah.
We didn't feel anything. But, we have to show you the
Moon Ross.
Right, that's our ghost name. That's where that's the inside joke. So going to the office. Car is still right here. Well, look at this front row VIP parking. Only in Monterey. Only in Monterey, exactly.
Last night, that crazy night with people driving on the wrong side of the road. Getting hit up for drugs.
Yep, exactly.
I did.
It didn't help that he had his hood on everything, so it was a guy in a Mercedes, red Mercedes, you know.
He wanted classy drugs, not that that ghetto stuff.
Exactly. So, and there was a mysterious code just
laying right there.
Laying right there on the side of the gas station. Nice looking coat, maybe $150 coat. And some SpongeBob or something right now, where we were. And we're ready to hit the aquarium and just get out of this place. And this is a room. I think Matt already said something on camera. Andy, do you have a review of this stay here?
Pretty good.
Yeah,
I didn't get swindled. My meal was excellent.
Excellent. Well, Samuel said, and so any. I mean, what about the people around here? What do you guys think about the?
They're like terrified of us.
Terrified.
Very bright.
Very, yeah, exactly.
Very bright. Very terrified of Mexicans.
Absolutely no females at all that I've seen walking around. Everybody shuts down at 9 o'clock. It looks like.
Yeah, pretty much.
Yeah, pretty so much.
They got wind of like, there's 4 Mexicans in town. Time to shut down the town.
But what was that little incident about when you accidentally said rape too loud?
I was singing that Anton Dotson song and raping everybody out here. And apparently, I didn't notice the couple standing next to us who just darted across the street. Because got the guy with the hat on and the hood on yelling rape out everywhere.
Yeah, exactly. They walk pretty fast again at the crosswalk, it looks like.
They didn't wait.
Oh, man. So
craziness. And
yeah, well, so, yeah, we'll see.
The highlight of the night, though, was about a cool job. All you need to know is they ate a pound and a half of shrimp.
Yeah, that was a pretty big feat. Yeah, I didn't think he can do it. I called him out on it. Even the waiter didn't think he can do it, but he handled it.